Blackstone Audio presents No Higher Power, Obama's War on Religious Freedom by Phyllis Schlafly and George Neumayr. This book is read by Dianna Dorman. Chapter 1. Coerced. Ominous shadows fall beneath Barack Obama's rainbow of hope and change. This book will illuminate the darkest one. His sweeping abuse of the American people's religious liberty, a right of conscience and free worship of God enshrined in the First Amendment of the U.S. Constitution. The policies of the Obama administration represent the greatest government-directed assault on religious freedom in American history. In the 2008 campaign, candidate Obama promised a transformative presidency. As president, he has delivered one. Through stealth and sophistry, he is gradually transforming America into a secularist and socialist dystopia along modern Western European lines. If you think his first term has been troubling, gird yourself for his second. The future casts its shadow backwards, wrote the late British writer Malcolm Muggeridge. In January 2012, we saw a shadow of Obama's imagined future for America when he decreed, through his Department of Health and Human Services Secretary Kathleen Sebelius, that all employers, including most religious ones, pay for the contraceptives, sterilizations, and abortion-inducing pills of their employees. Today, the department is announcing that the final rule on preventive health services will ensure that women with health insurance coverage will have access to the full range of the Institute of Medicine's recommended preventive services, including all FDA-approved forms of contraception, said Sebelius on January 20, 2012. Women will not have to forego these services because of expensive copays or deductibles, or because an insurance plan doesn't include contraceptive services. This rule is consistent with the laws in a majority of states which already require contraception coverage in health plans, and includes the exemption in the interim final rule allowing certain religious organizations not to provide contraception coverage. Beginning August 1, 2012, most new and renewed health plans will be required to cover these services without cost sharing for women across the country. Sebelius's phrase, certain religious organizations, excluded the vast majority of religious schools, hospitals, and charitable institutions throughout the country. Obama had arrogated to himself the right to define which organizations qualify as religious and which do not. Most religious schools, hospitals, and charitable groups don't meet his definition as it turns on narrow and unconstitutional criteria. Under Obama's definition, a religious institution must have the inculcation of religious values as its purpose and must primarily employ and serve persons who share its religious tenets. That would obviously exclude Catholic hospitals, as well as many Catholic, Protestant, and Jewish schools and charities. Regarding herself as generous, Sebelius informed horrified members of these groups that she was granting them extra time with which to adjust their religious views to the regulatory decree. After evaluating comments, we have decided to add an additional element to the final rule, said Sebelius. Nonprofit employers who, based on religious beliefs, do not currently provide contraceptive coverage in their insurance plan will be provided an additional year until August 1, 2013, to comply with the new law. The secularist hubris of the Obama administration left religious leaders stunned. In effect, the president is saying we have a year to figure out how to violate our consciences, said a frustrated
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.